To get started running unit tests with the Java plugin, all you need to do is place your tests in the source test Java folder. You can, of course, change the location of your test code by configuring the test source set. The only thing we have to manually configure is our test dependencies. In this example, we're using JUnit as our testing framework, so we have to add a JUnit dependency to the test compile configuration. Running our tests is easy, just run the test task. You'll notice Gradle has to perform a bunch of other tasks before it can actually run our tests. It has to compile our Java source, and then compile our test source, and finally it can run the tests. In this case, the build was successful, indicating that all of our tests passed. Gradle also provides detailed reports on our test execution. These reports are placed in the build reports directory. Let's take a look at one of these reports. In this case, you can see we have one test and that the test was successful. Of course, in a real project, you'd have many tests. Now I've gone and edited our test so it'll fail. Let's see what happens when we run the test this time. Oh no, our build failed. Let's see what went wrong. Execution failed for task test. There were failing tests. All right, we expected that. Let's check out the report. Looking at the report tells us we ran one test and that it failed. And then we can even look at our test class to see the full stack trace of what went wrong.